Hello students, how are you? So this video is for those students who couldn't attend and even for those who couldn't hear on this. So we will discuss here the topics that were taught on the online classes, that is on 17th August. So let's discuss what are the topics that we have discussed. So in this, on that day we have discussed that how wool is obtained and how we make a fabric from the wool. We have discussed the different processes, what are the steps that are included to make woolen clothes or sweaters. So here we will discuss about wool. As I have discussed in the last class, that wool, this wool, the reason why we wear wool in winter season, and also we have discussed about the where, how it is obtained. It is obtained from where? It is obtained from the fleece of the sheep, goats, fleece of the animals. We extract this fleece from the animals, and from there we process it and we get the wool. So we will discuss about the processes. Now, wool. First we have to know that where do we get this wool? We get the wool from different animals. What are the animals? Like first is sheep, second is Angora goat, third is yak, fourth is Kashmiri goat, fourth is llama, and the fifth is alpaca. So these are the animals, and these animals have a thick hair in their body, and we extract their hair, we remove their hair, and from their hair we make a wool. Now, what kind of wool we get from these animals? From sheep, we get the common wool, the wool that we wear, the sweaters that we wear is actually made up from sheep, from the hair of the sheep. So this is a common wool available in market. From Angora goat we get what? We get Angora wool. And where it is available? Where do we find these animals? We generally find this in hilly region like Jammu and Kashmir, this Angora goat is found. And the yak, what kind of wool we get? We get yak wool. And where this yak is found? This yak is found in Tibet and Ladakh. Kashmiri goat, we get what? Kashmiri shawl. Kashmiri wool, or we can say Pashmini shawl. These shawl are actually very soft and very thin. You will generally find that how this thin shawl can protect her, but it is very warm also. When you put this shawl around your body, you will feel warm. It is thin, but is at the same time it keeps you warm. And where we get this Kashmir? As you can see, that Kashmiri means it is generally available in Kashmir, this kind of goat, Kashmiri goats, and at the same time it is a soft wool. And what about the llama and alpaca? The llama and alpaca are actually found in America, South America. These are not found in India. These are all found in the South America, a llama and alpaca. So here we have found that we get wool from different type of animals, and from different type of animals we get a different kind of wool. So we have seen. Now we will discuss to the next topic. So we have discussed the different animals and different kind of wool we get from. So generally, the common wool is obtained from where? The common wool that we available in market is obtained from sheep. And so most of the wool is obtained from the sheep. And these sheep have two different type of hair. two different type of hair, that is coarse thick hair and fine hair. And this fine hair is actually used for making wool. Coarse thick hair as are actually quite thick in nature. It won't make you comfortable. But this fine hair, when we wear sweater, we feel comfortable because the wool are made from this fine hair. This fine hair actually is used for making thick, and it is actually close to the skin. And this hair is present in the outer part. Okay, now to increase the production of wool and at the same time to increase the quality of the wool, so what actually farmers do, they actually do the selective breeding. Suppose they will take a parent, two parents, parent A and parent B, and these both parents will have some fine hair. They will select the parents who will have this fine hair. So they will breed this. After doing the selective breeding, they will produce a child, and this child, you will see, it is actually maximum of the time it is found that this child inherit the fine hair from his parents. Like jemon, for example tomar ma jodi lomba hoy, tomar baba jodi lomba hoy, tahole tumio lomba hobe. We have seen in the most of the cases. Similarly, from here also, if the mother has a fine hair, if a father has a fine hair, then child also will inherit the fine hair. And as a result, now see, from mother we will also get fine hair, from parents also we will get fine hair, and from the child also we will get a fine hair. So in this way we increase the quality of the wool and as well as the production of the wool. So why it is done? Why selective breeding is done? So this process is called selective breeding. Selective breeding means we select parents, we breed them, and we produce a child which inherit the qualities of their parents. And why it is done? The reason is to increase the production and the quality of wool. So this is the reason why selective breeding is done. Now we will see that sheep is, so selective breeding, we have different kind of sheep. For selective breeding, we also have different breeds of sheep. Like we have a different breeds of dog, German Shepherds, Labrador, Doberman, Pug, Golden Retriever. These are the breeds of dogs. Similarly, the sheep has also different breeds, and by selecting the breeds we do this selective breed. By selecting the different breeds, we produce a child which inherit the fine hair from the parents, and from there we produce wool. So what are the breeds? Let's see. Now comes to different breeds of wool sheep. Different breeds of sheep. These different breeds of sheep gives us what? Different quality of wools. And this, from this different quality of wool, we make different kind of fabrics. And these different breeds of sheep are not available in particular. They are available in across the India. Available all over the India. Suppose Lohi. For example, first take Lohi. Lohi gives us a good quality of wool. Good quality of wool, which is actually used for making sweaters, because the more the quality, the more it is comfortable to wear. So this kind of wool, the wool that we get from Lohi, is actually used for making what? It is used for making sweaters. And where it is available? It is available in Rajasthan and Punjab. Rampur Bush hair, रामपुर बुश है, इट इज फाउंड इन उत्तर प्रदेश एंड हिमाचल प्रदेश. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वूल वी गेट? वी गेट अ ब्राउन कलर्ड वूल. ब्राउन कलर्ड वूल. नाली इज फाउंड इन राजस्थान हरियाणा. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वूल वी गेट? कारपेट वूल, द वूल विच इज यूज फॉर मेकिंग कारपेट्स. बकरवाल फाउंड इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. एंड सिंस इट इज फाउंड इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, द क्वालिटी ऑफ द वूल इज वेरी सॉफ्ट. And since it is soft, it is actually used for making what? It is used for making shawl. Marwari is found in Gujarat. And what kind of wool we get? Rough or harsh texture wool. And this wool is actually used for making foot mat. This coarse wool is actually used for making foot mat. Foot mat means pamocha. माने जेहेतु इधर दीज आर क्वाइट हार्ड, दे हैव रफ टेक्सचर, सो वी कांट वेयर इट. सो वेयर इट इज यूज्ड? जनरली इट इज यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग फुट मैट. एंड पठानवाड़ी इज आल्सो फाउंड इन गुजरात. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वूल वी गेट? द दिस काइंड ऑफ वूल इज यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग होशियारी. होशियारी मीन्स सॉक्स, टाइट्स, द सॉक्स वी वेयर, द वुलन हैंड ग्लव्स we wear, these are all made from Pathanwari wool. Pathanwari, the wool we get from Pathanwari. So as you can see, these are the different breeds of sheep, and from different breeds of sheep we get different quality of wool, and from this different quality of wool we make different kind of fabrics. From Lohi we make sweaters. Rampur Bushehr gives brown fleece. Nali gives carpet wool, wool making used for making carpets. Bakharwal is soft wool used for making shawl. Marwari gives coarse wool, so uncomfortable. Coarse wool means rough texture, so generally used for making foot mat. And Pathanwari the wool we get is actually used for making socks. And these are the places where we find these breeds of sheep. Now we will discuss the steps. Steps to convert this hair to wool and then wool to fabric. So from sheep hair to wool fiber and from fiber to fabric. So here we will discuss that. The first step is removal of hair. Because until and unless we remove the hair, how can we get wool? So removal of hair, and here along with hair a thin layer of skin. Along with hair, thin layer of skin is also removed. Thin layer of skin is also removed. And at the same time, it is done when? It is done in summer. Why it is done in summer? It has two advantages. Because in summer, what we feel? We feel sweaty. Okay? বেশি জামা পরলেই গরম লাগে. তো সাপোজ নাও থিঙ্ক অফ দ্যাট শিপ হ্যাভিং সো মাচ ফার অরাউন্ড দেয়ার বডি, সো দে গেট এক্সস্ট, দে উইল ফিল স্টিকি. সো অ্যান্ড সো ফার্স্ট অ্যাডভান্টেজ ইজ দ্যাট ইট উইল কুল দেয়ার বডি ইফ উই রিমুভ কুল দেয়ার বডি অর কিপ দেয়ার বডি কুল ইফ উই রিমুভ হেয়ার. And at the same time, it is a perfect time for removal of hair, not only just for their, because it's a summer season, it will make their body too much hot and it may, as a result, they may die. But at the same time, by the time we reach winter, the hair will grow. Sufficient amount of hair will grow. মানে ঠিক পুরোপুরি ভালোভাবে hair growth হয়ে যাবে. So at the same time it will protect them. So if we do it rainy season, তাহলে কি হবে? By the time they will reach the winter, the hair will not be fully grown. চুল ভালোভাবে পুরো মানে ফার গুলো ভালোভাবে grow করবে না. As a result, they will feel cold. And as a result, it may become hazardous for them. So summer is a perfect time for removal of hair from. And why? Another question comes around is, when along with hair, so when you're cutting your hair, it does not hurt. But along with hair, a thin layer of skin is removed. Doesn't it hurt? No, it doesn't hurt. It doesn't hurt. Why? Because the uppermost skin are dead. Uppermost skin are dead. The skin, the cells which are dead, it does not cause any pain. So it won't hurt or it won't cause any pain because the uppermost skin of the sheep are dead. Now comes to the second step. What is second step? What actually? The second step is scouring. What is scouring? The scouring is washing of wool, washing of the hair or fleece that we have got from the sheep. Because they are not hygienic, they are not clean. So what we will do? We will clean the wool. So it can be done by the two process. One by machine. So nowadays it is done by machine. But when there was no machine, how it is done? They used to take a big tanks, and in that tank they fill water, and in that tank water is filled, and then the wool or the fleece is added. So as a result, what actually happened? The oil, grease, dirts that are present in the fleece or wool are removed. So scouring is a process by which the fleece are cleaned or washed, and in that process the oil, grease or dirts are thoroughly removed. And after that, once the scouring is done, after scouring, since it is washed with water, the wool get wet. So it is dried. Now comes to the processes. What we do after scouring? After scouring, we do shotting. Shotting means grouping. We used to separate the different kind of wools in a different way. Suppose you have gone to the market and you have brought various things. But after coming home, you used to separate the things and keep it in a different place. Like we used to short this so that it becomes easily available. So here also, the wool of different texture. Some wool are soft in nature, some are hard in nature. So different texture, different colors. Some are brown, some are black. Different lengths. Some are small, some are long. So different texture, color and length are separated. So wool of different colors, different texture, different length are separated. Now comes to fourth one, that is removal of burrs. What is removal of burrs? Small fluffy fibers are called bars. What actually it is? It is a wool, and here the small bars are coming out. Mane jokhoni amra sweater ta onek din dhore pori, you have seen that some small wools ektu ki hoye jay rui moton rui uthe ashe. That rui uthe asha take, that's rui is actually bars. And after, once we have removed the bars, we repeat what? Scouring process and dry it. We repeat this process until and unless we find no bar. Once we find the no bars in it, we move to next process. Mane scouring kollam, abar wet kollam, abar again we will find if there is any bars or not. If we find there is no bar, then we will move to the next process. And what is the next process? That is dyeing. What is dyeing? Dyeing is a coloring of wool by using dye. Now see, dyeing natural. What are the natural colors of wool? Natural color of wool that we obtain. The natural color of wools are white, black, and brown. See, these are the natural color of wool. Now, so if three colors are available, it will be boring. We have colorful sweaters. And how it if we get that colorful sweater? We actually perform dyeing. Dyeing is coloring of wool by using dye. Dye is a substance, colored substance, which actually color the wool. Now comes to the last process. Fourth is rolling process. What is rolling? Rolling is making of yarn. What is yarn? Yarn means jigulu dhaga, that is wool, thread of wools, that is yarn. Now these yarns are of two types, that is longest fiber and one is shortest fiber. What is longest and shortest fiber? The longest fiber is actually used for making what? Used for making sweaters. By knitting we make sweaters. And from the shortest fibers we do what? We do weaving or spinning. And from after spinning the shortest fiber yarn, we make what? We make woolen clothes. So these are the process where we ultimately we get the fabric or clothes, woolen clothes from wool. So now recap, summarize it. So we have seen while processing from sheep to hair, it includes 6 steps. And what are they? First is shearing. Shearing is removal of hair, along with thin layer. And when it is done, in summer, because so that by the time we reach winter, the hairs will be fully grown up. Now what we will do? The next step process is, scouring. Scouring is actually cleaning. Cleaning and washing. Washing of the fleece we get from here. Now comes to the third process. Third place means shorting. Shorting means separating different wool, different texture, color, length wool. Now comes to fourth process. What it is done? Removal of bars. And removal of bars is done until and unless we get no bars. When we get no bars, then we move to the next process. That is what? That is dyeing. What is dyeing? Dyeing is coloring of wool. Different colors are added by using dye. And the last process is rolling. From this rolling, what we get? We get two kind of yarns, that is short and one is long. From short we make what? We make We do spinning, weaving, and we get woolen clothes. And from long fiber yarn, we actually make, while knitting, we make sweater. So these are the complete 6 steps from sheep hair to fabric. We make different substances. Now while doing this, actually it is done in industries, they face some occupational hazards. How it is arises due to poor working condition. Poor working condition. Poor working condition. Until and unless the working condition is improved, if the working condition is poor, unhygienic, then the person walking over there faces different kind of disease. And what kind of disease? That in shorting job, when shorters, the person who is doing shorter, they actually get infected. They get infected by bacteria called anthrax. What is this anthrax do? It is actually person actually it causes fatal blood disease. It causes a fatal blood disease. So shorter sometimes gets affected by this anthrax, and what is actually do? It is kind of it arises some kind of blood disease. And even sometimes this man small pieces of wool causes respiratory problems or disease. Why? Because these small pieces of wool, when you are constantly shorting the small pieces of wool and long pieces of wool, this wool is inhaled. We mistakenly inhale them, and as a result it gets stuck. When you inhale them through your windpipe, it gets stuck, and as a result the person faces many respiratory problems and disease. So these are the occupational hazards that are found that actually people suffer due to the poor working condition, and as a result they face different kind of disease. One is anthrax, that is which causes fatal blood disease. Another is respiratory problems. So till now we have discussed this much. In the next class we will discuss about the silk.